those 7 years. He was always willing to help us out, always willing to serve the help unit, whether that was coming out at 7 a.m. with donuts to when we were camping out here at Beaumont, to letting us camp up at school, letting us store our trailers up at school, helping us out with any of our service projects we were planning on doing, providing us ideas for Eagle Scout projects for the Boy Scouts that they were doing. And generally, anything I pretty much asked him, he always said yes to. Or if he didn't say yes, he said, well, what if we do it this way? I never had to worry about that. And it was very easy to run this troop packed in with the support of that unit. Now, Dr. D was a scout as well. And though he never earned his Eagle Scout, we'll blame Cheryl for that.
My mom did.
He lives up to those ideals every day in his service, not just to the troop or to the pack, but to the school and to all those who know him. So we have a couple things here to present to Dr. D. How many of you present the first plaque?
Yeah.
It says, in sincere recognition of our... In sincere appreciation and recognition of your outstanding leadership and dedicated service, Dr. Chad Dickemper, Pack 61 and Troop 61. And so coming here and getting to see your accomplishments and be a part of that process has been very, very special. And I thank you for that. And I know I'm being long.
No.
Two more things. So important that you guys don't give up. And I'll tell you, I'll be honest, what happened with me. I done my Eagle Scout project. I got all the way back. Everything was ready. All I needed to do
even when I got my doctorate, even when I became doctor, my mom was
I know she is. She said she is.
This is great. I wish you would have gotten your ego down. Because what you guys are doing matters. And what you're doing today and during your camp out will remember. Now, when I was a scout, there were stories about this place, and one of them was the Beaumont Big Boy. And so I approached Mr. Bus a few years ago, and I said, I have this crazy idea. What if I just show up dressed as Bigfoot, and I pass out Bigfoot beef jerky? And so, first driving around through here in a Bigfoot costume, you get some really interesting looks. And then no one knew it was me. And some of the parents were like, is this part of what goes on here? Like it was Six Flags. And then I did it again, and people started to figure it out. And there are some traditions that I really feel have to continue. And Chris, since you've been my partner in crime, what I would like to do is pass this on to you.
I never scared, I'm not sure.
With the hope that you make mischief and continue the traditions and keep finding a way to